I just want to get, this is a passage, it's on page 4 of the text and, that we just got, and is headed, Sondland Briefs Zelensky Ahead of Call with President Trump. And I just want to, it just says, this is on July 19th, 2019. Ambassador Volker, Ambassador Sondland, Mr. Taylor had the following exchange about the specific goal for the upcoming telephone call between President Trump and the Ukrainian president. Okay, so it says, Kurt Volker, can we three do a call together, say noon, Washington? And then Gordon Sondland writes back, looks like POTUS call tomorrow. I spike, and then it's directly to Zelensky and gave him a full briefing. He's got it. Okay, and then Gordon Sondland said, sure. And then Kurt Volker, good. Had breakfast with Rudy this morning. Teeing up call with Yermak Monday. Must have helped. Most important is for Zelensky to say that he will help investigation and address any specific personnel issues if there are any.
It's great evidence. It's a prosecutor's dream. So this is why this is such good evidence. First of all, it's in the words of the real insiders, the people who understand the dynamic. It is their own words. There's no spin ability. And it's from the time when this was all happening. And what you see here is the people who are really on the inside, who are working these channels, understand that really what comes through all these texts, there's only one thing that Donald Trump cares about, and that's these investigations to benefit his own political campaign. It comes through from the direct players who were involved, and it corroborates, it backs up, it supports the call that we've all seen. It supports what the whistleblower has told us. So this is really important evidence. It gives us a real insight into what was going on.
Okay, so for those who say, well, we don't need I don't know, I guess you're going to have evidence of a crime, or others say you don't need a crime. What does this say to you?
Well, I think this helps build the case that there is a crime. Correct. You do not need a crime in order to impeach, and abuse of power is enough. But I also do think we have a crime, and this builds the case that there was an exchange, a bribery, a quid pro quo, whatever you want to call it. And it's pretty darn close to an actual stated quid pro quo. Here's the deal.
Okay. Okay. So that was a Ukraine call. And then we have the other thing here. Kylie, let me bring you in, because tell us about the new CNN reporting of a call the president had with Chinese President Xi Jinping. This was in August.
Yeah, so we are now learning that there was a call between President Trump and Xi Jinping back in July. And during that call, President Trump did bring up Joe Biden. He also brought up Elizabeth Warren. And he brought them up in the political prospect sense. He was not, at that point, encouraging Xi Jinping to investigate Joe Biden. He was talking about his political rivals here, right? Joe Biden and Elizabeth Warren being two of them. Now, this is significant because just today, President Trump went further and publicly suggested that China investigate Joe Biden. But this shows that Joe Biden was always on his mind when it comes to China, and he did bring it up in a phone call with Xi Jinping earlier this summer.
Okay, yeah, so listen, I got that wrong. The Chinese call was in June. The Ukrainian call was in July. The Ukrainian call was later, but we found out about that one first. The one with the Chinese president was in June, and we're just finding out about that one. The president suggested China start an investigation today. Let's listen to this.
And by the way, likewise, China should start an investigation into the Bidens, because what happened in China is just about as bad as what happened with Ukraine.
So now we know that the president's conversation with Xi Jinping was moved to the secret server. Seems that he was getting this out before that information became public, Kylie.
Yeah, that's right. He did get it out today. He talked to reporters publicly about it as we were working on this story. But I want to note that it definitely took the Chinese by surprise. I spoke with a Chinese diplomat today who said to me that it was chaotic. They were trying to process these reports, and they were asking allies of Trump if Trump was really serious, if he really wanted them to investigate Joe Biden. Now, I'm told that Trump allies said, yes, that is a way to gain points with this president. But I also was told by a Chinese diplomat that they didn't want to get involved into the domestic politics of the U.S. But we have yet to see a formal response from the Chinese government on this.
All right. Thank you all. I appreciate you helping us with this break.